Hi folks, time to machine the connecting rod. I've mounted this up in a lathe between the regional chuck and a lathe center. I turned down 1/2 by 1/4 inch bosses either end of the shaft so that I could switch it around 180 degrees. I've also marked out the hole positions and drilled a 1/8 pilot hole. I'm now going to turn down the center, which is going to be the hardest bit of the lot as it's very thin and of course an interrupted cut till you get down a bit. So I'll bring you along and show you if I have success or failure. Hopefully success. This is probably going to be the hardest bit I've machined. So we'll give it a go. With a little bit of coolant. Carbide chip still is handling the interrupted cuts pretty well. Breaking the chips good. to speed, up to speed, now the pass will be up to cut. Cutting it off better. Ripping the metal off now. Finish is not fantastic, but it'll be a filed hand finish anyhow. Keep going, folks, and I'll bring you back soon. Right, well, we've now got a half a degree on the compound. I'm just using the compound to take the light cuts to give me my taper. I've roughed it out off camera. Just finishing it off here. This will be a hand file finish anyhow. The specifications call for the thin end to be 1/4 inch. Oh, it's my noisy friend. He wants to be fed. That should do it. It's actually not too bad a finish. As I said, it'll be hand file. I'm sorry if it's was out of focus a bit, but it doesn't like. I've left a little bit down this end. See if I can get you a little bit closer. I'm going to put a radius tool, high speed steel radius tool. Ooh, too far. And radius the ends. So I'll bring you back when it's done. Well, that's the taper done. It's all ready for that milling machine. Drilled and milled, so we'll proceed on. It'll still need a polish when I'm finished, but it's looking pretty good actually. I'm quite pleased so far. Okay. I'm going to take 60 power off the side. These are 10-hour cuts. Using power feed always helps. Center drill the bush. Probably drilled a quarter of an inch. This is a phosphorus bronze bush that I'm going to put in the end of the connecting rod. We'll change that over to the drill. Just put a pilot hole down this bush. About 15 mil deep. We'll change that over and put the finished size drill in. Just running a quarter inch rammer. I've made the Conrod phosphorus bronze bush. It's a very, very light press fed into the Conrod, so I'll press it in and the Conrod will be finished. Okay, the bearing, the phosphorus bronze bearing is now pressed into the Conrod. It has a thrust face on the back side and it protrudes through a few foul on the front side for another thrust face. The plans don't call for this, but I can't see the point in running a stainless steel pin in a steel Conrod. That just does not present good engineering practice. So I now have a phosphorus bronze bush in there and hopefully it will wear a lot better, and it's replaceable as well. Okay folks, that's it for the Conrod. I've done a test fit. and I have about 5 thou side clay between the bush facing and the crank pin. I may put an oiler on this conrod as well. I'll have a think about that. But I'll just put it in there just to show the fit and make sure it wasn't binding. I think that'll be good. So until next time, thank you for watching this video, and the next one will be on the bearing blocks. Thank you.